Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me today is Dan Blondal from Nano One Materials. Dan, good to see you again. How are you?
Great, thanks you. Great to be here.
Dan, yeah, good to see you again. Exciting news today as the company has announced that it has formed a memorandum of understanding with an unnamed auto company. Before we talk about the details on that, just give us a brief summary of your relationship with this company.
Yeah, this is an auto company that we have been working with for a number of years, and we are engaged in a research project to prove out some sort of fundamental materials that they had envisaged, and we were able to prove it out with our process and through a series of battery testing. It ended quite successfully and has resulted in an ongoing relationship.
So what will be the new focus here?
So the focus that we announced today is on developing cathode materials to go into an automotive scale battery. The specific materials that we're talking about are LNMO, so lithium nickel manganese oxide batteries. They're free of cobalt. They're actually rich in manganese, so it's a dominantly manganese based battery with a balance of lithium and nickel, and so relatively inexpensive. This type of material is fast charging and long lasting and high voltage, so it actually improves the simplicity of batteries. Could lead to less modules inside a battery pack, reduce the cost, complexity, and of course improve the chargeability of the batteries.
And this will all be done, from my understanding, using Nano One's one-pot process. Just remind us about how that works.
Yeah, so our one-pot process kind of underpins everything we do. And basically, it differs from the way industry does it because we take lithium, nickel, manganese, cobalt. It all goes into one reactor where where these chemicals react to form a powder, a slurry that forms in the reaction. We dry that, and then we thermally process it in a furnace. The idea is that by doing this, we can use alternative sources of lithium, nickel, manganese, and cobalt, for instance, and which are lower cost and less wasteful. That drives down costs, improves the environmental footprint, and ultimately allows us to make a very unique material that, of course, our automotive partners are quite excited about moving forward with.
So give us a sense of what we can expect from the partnerships. What kind of benchmarks can we expect?
Well, listen, we start out with a whole bunch of evaluation work. So we make materials, we test them. There's a lot of back and forth. At the same time, in parallel to that, we're also doing sort of an economic feasibility analysis on the supply chain. So we're looking, okay, where's the nickel going to come from? Where's the manganese going to come from? Where's the lithium going to come from? How do we drive down the costs and environmental footprint of those things and make this an economically viable system? So both of these things are going on in parallel, and they're going to be obviously the results of the battery testing and the economics are going to drive the adoption of these materials and lead to, hopefully, a version of this next gen battery that's going to be using our materials.
So when do you think we can expect the next update from you?
We'll do our best to update obviously the company's unnamed at this point, and so we can't go into a lot of specifics, but you know, they are a very large multinational auto company, and as much as we can, we will update the our shareholders and the market with various sort of points of progress. So we'll be talking about the results as much as we can, and in a more general sense, and of course the ultimately, if the MOU switches into a more meaningful relationship, we'll have to bring that out to the media as well. So all of that happening over the next 6 months, year, and 2 years. Obviously, it takes a while to build out a battery system, but obviously the initial stages of this are extremely important. They are stage gated. There are points where we kind of hit go, no go points. And as we go through those, we'll certainly be bringing that to the markets.
Exciting stuff. Dan, thanks so much.
You're most welcome.